rehab facility is under fire following the deaths of several patients. In the past 12 months, three people have died while being treated at Narconon Arrowhead near McAllister. The most recent, a 20-year-old Owosso woman, was found dead early Thursday morning. Our Tasmani talked with her father, who is searching for answers.
Stacey Murphy had just finished her detox program with Narconon, which earned her a day off to be with her family. That was on Wednesday, and by Thursday morning, her father got a phone call saying his daughter had died of an overdose back at rehab.
This is a drug addict. It's not the perception you think of a drug addict. And people have to realize it can be their own child.
Robert Murphy is coming to grips with the death of his daughter, Stacey. A vibrant, bubbly girl who he says had the world at her fingertips until she fell in with the wrong crowd.
Stacey grew up in the church. She did the sports. So sweet and so bubbly, you just don't know just what the struggle is that's going on inside of her. And she was seeking help.
Murphy says when Stacey's drug addiction escalated to heroin, she agreed to go to Narconon Arrowhead. It's a drug and alcohol rehab facility that treats with teachings inspired by the Church of Scientology.
We went there for her to be cured, safe. She has so much potential.
But she was found dead Thursday morning. Her father says she snuck drugs into the facility following a one-day visit home.
My first thought was, well, Stacey did what she did to herself. But after hearing what they did know, there was no reason for her to die.
Murphy says Narconon employees knew Stacey was on the verge of an overdose, but instead of providing her with the medical attention she needed, Murphy says his daughter was put in a room and left to die.
They did not call Avis's parents. They did not call a medical team. There was a shift change apparently at 7 o'clock. Nobody found her till 9:20.
Two other patients have died at Narconon this year, including an Oklahoma man, Gabriel Graves. The Pittsburgh County Sheriff's Office and the OSBI are investigating all three deaths. Sheriff Joel Kern says criminal and negligence charges are possible, though the investigation is still in the early stages.
We just hate it for this family. I just feel for them that they lost a child.
And for Murphy and his family, they'll continue to cope while searching for answers and demanding change.
All I can say is not safe. My daughter's death, she could have been prevented easily. And I don't want her death to be in vain. There's procedures that either have to be changed or this place has to be shut down.
Narconon Arrowhead CEO issued a statement saying, "It is always deeply saddening when drug addiction takes a life or destroys a family. It hurts when a young person passes before their time." You can find his full statement inside this story at newson6.com. Tess Mani, News on 6 Tonight.